I started to create a lesson for my students. And then I thought, you know what, maybe I will just make it as a YouTube video so everybody can enjoy this content. Zo created some changes on Zo campaigns. I released some videos about it, but today I want to create a lesson about the workflows. The workflows will be a very interesting feature that can allow you to send drip campaigns or send messages when something happens. For example, when there is a birth date, an email will be sent, or when there is some kind of an event, or maybe want to send multiple messages, one message today, another one next month, and next month. So you basically plan some kind of a storyline. So when a lead comes in, or when a contact, or when something happens in your system, the person will start getting messages in a planned manner. So you set once a beautiful sequence, and then the system is doing the rest forever. And that's what I like about the system. So if you look on my system, first of all, we need to create some kind of a sync between Zo CRM and Zo campaigns. Because the idea is that when you have, let's say, leads in your Zo CRM, new leads coming in, they will automatically be going to Zo campaigns. And in order to do that, you will need to go to your contacts in Zo campaigns. You will need to click on Sync Services, and you will need to click on New Sync. You will select the immediate sync, and you will select, in this example, the leads, but you can go with custom modules or contacts. In general, in lots of my videos, I recommend to have only two modules that you will have people. It will be leads or contacts. And this is one of the reasons that when you have people in leads or contacts, any system that you are going to work with will know exactly how to integrate with. So you don't need to go crazy with the custom stuff. Okay, let's click on leads. The sync name, we are going to call it all leads. And I will create a new mailing list and we'll call it all leads. So basically, every time that a new lead is coming into my Zo CRM, it will automatically be synced into the all leads system. Let's click on next. In this page, the system like to know how to map fields from Zo CRM to Zo campaigns. And in my case, I will have only the first name, last name, and the email. That's enough. Now, in some cases, you like to go also with the lead status. So in Zo CRM, I will take the lead status and I will push it into Zo campaigns. And that will allow us later on to create some criteria. So let's say that you're running a campaign only on your lost leads, people that didn't want to work with you. And then you can maybe build trust with them, or people that did have some kind of a deal with you. You can send maybe upsells. So, you know, or maybe more deals. So you can really play based on the status of the person. So I will grab also the lead status, so later on we can do cool stuff around it. Let's continue. And once you set those syncs, it takes about a few minutes for those syncs to take place. And once it will run, you will have the details of how many leads were synced and everything around it. Next, we are going to click on automation and we are going with the workflows. And we are going to create our first workflow. Just to be fair, I created about 5,000 of them, but that will be my first workflow for the last 1 hour. And let's click on custom workflow. If you want, you can also select from existing templates. I always like to go custom, so we'll do that. And let's call it leads drip campaign. In this example, I like to simulate whenever a new lead comes into my system, I like to build trust. So every 2 days, this lead will get a different email that will show him maybe what are we doing with our customers, or what type of services we provide, or maybe stories of existing clients that are using our system and they like to talk about it. Anything that can build trust, or how many years you're in the business, or maybe certifications that you have. Anything that can build trust, that's very good for new leads. On the left side, you will have triggers, process, and actions. We are going to deal with the trigger and actions in this example. The trigger in my case will be a list entry when a new lead goes into a new list. If you remember a few minutes ago, we set a sync. The sync is going to push leads from CRM into Zoho campaigns. Now, that's sending the leads. Let me just go to Zoho campaigns. So that will send the leads into a specific list, and we called it all leads. So when the all leads will receive a new lead, basically a new contact, it will be the list entry. So I will drag and drop the list entry, but as you can see here, you have a bunch of different triggers that can start this drip campaign. I will click on the list entry and I will select the all leads, which this is the list that I like to trigger. And let's click on save. Next, there is a process. I'm not going to deal with the process at all, and we are going to go with actions. Next, and this is the most common, you will start to plan one email at a time. So let's say that you will have, you know, a bunch of emails. For now, let's start with the first one. So email number one, I will click on create message. Okay, you have different topics. Let's say that this is the topic here is marketing, and we have a video that I released not too long ago that shows you exactly what are the topics, and that will be test and the sender details. Okay, save. Okay, I'm not going to deal with how to create an email. We have enough videos on the channel dealing with that. Right now, I'm just running fast, just creating some test email, just so I can show you how to use the workflows, because this is the reason that I created this lesson. So here, I'm going to send for Zoho review. When you're sending to Zoho review, it's not really sending your email. It's just sending it to Zoho. They are verifying that the email is legit, and then they will approve so you can send it. We are going to click Take Me to Canvas. Okay, and now we are going to create our next email. Now, before we create the next email, if you think about it, we have this message, and this message is supposed to be sent, let's say, right now, the moment that you created, the person went into the lead system. But the second one needs to be after 2 days. So I need to create some kind of an email delay. So I will go with the wait time. The wait time will be basically how many hours or days to wait. So I will have, for example, 2 days. So send it after 2 days. 1 second. Okay. So send it after 2 days. And here you can have more abilities to send it in specific hours. So it will be like working hours and so on. So let's say between 9 to 5. That's fine. No Saturday, no Sunday. So if it will fall on the Sunday or Saturday, it will go to the next business day. Okay, and now I can go and plan my next email. Now, you have also with the workflows, you have more abilities. You can update some information in Zoho CRM. Let's say that, for example, whenever a lead is opened, then when someone click on a link in those messages, or when someone opened the email, you can send a notification to Zoho CRM so your marketer will know that the person opened it, and maybe it will start getting different type of emails, or maybe a salesperson will connect with him because now there is an interest. So there are a bunch of things that you can do with those Zoho campaigns workflows, but I wanted you to see how easy is to just drag and drop. And the main usage is what I just showed you right now. Basically, to have a list, whenever someone goes to the list using the sync, it will start getting messages, and between the messages, you will have a delay. Whenever you're done, you click on activate. Okay, here there is message incomplete is because Zoho did not approve this message, and this message was not created yet, right? And this is why I'm getting it. But whenever you finish with the messages and you activate, it will start running automatically for you. One thing to note, when you're activating a workflow, you cannot change it anymore. You can only freeze it. You can only stop it, but you cannot make changes to it. So make sure that you have a good workflow with all the emails and it's planned properly, and only then activate it. I hope I was able to give you some value in this session. If you like it, thumbs up is always appreciated. I will see you in the next session.